Alright, in this video, I'm going to show you, give you a big picture of the movement of uric acid in your body and other acids, and give you a big picture of the formation of gout so that you can have a clearer picture on how to get rid of it, and with that, it cure your gout. Alright, let's start with a scenario of a factory or manufacturing plant. Alright, imagine this is the factory. Okay, this is the factory. This is X scenario. This is a scenario X. First, this is the factory. This factory, and this is the storage. This is a storage, and this is other area that you can dump or put your products. Right? Okay. Here you get now. It's a metaphor of the overall layout of your body system, so that it makes you easier to understand. Okay. What I mean by factory is actually the kidney. The kidney is the way. Because we are talking about uric acid, the management of uric acid of your body, and this is the bloodstream, this is the bloodstream, and this is the bloodstream, and this is the interstitial fluid. Interstitial fluid is these are the cells in your body, these are the cells, these are the cells, these are the cells, these are the cells. Interstitial fluid is the area between the cells. So these are interstitial fluid, and lastly, this is the joint. This is your joint, this is your joint, this is your joint, this is your joint, right, okay. So this is a synovial fluid, this is the fluid inside the joint. Okay, this is the movement, these are the places where the uric acid is stored in your body. Naturally, uric acid shouldn't be here, it shouldn't be too much or shouldn't be at all inside the interstitial fluid or the muscle layers of your body, and it shouldn't be inside the joint as well. All right, but what happens if you in the case of scenario X is imagine this is a factory. So the every day the production is maximum capacity is 100. That means production means the excretion of uric acid. So imagine, all right, if you input 200 units of raw material, that means into the factory, your kidney. So, and the maximum capacity of it is at 100 per day. So, and maximum capacity of 100. That means there's an excess of 100, and which is beyond the ability of the kidney to get rid of. So where does it dump it? It's dumped into the storage. So there's excess of stock. So as imagine this is your warehouse. Your warehouse can only store maximum 500 units of acids. Or whatever the excess stocks in your excess raw material, I would say in this case, so raw material. So it takes only because the excess, because your manufacturing capacity or the filtering capacity of your kidney is 100 units per day. So there's an excess of 100 units in a day. So within five days, it will fill up the ability, the spaces available in your bloodstream to store the uric acid. But on the day six, where does the uric acid go? Because you keep on inputting, I mean, you keep on taking high protein diets, drinking beers, which input of new uric acid is keep on coming here, So there's an excess of uric acid after day five, for example. So, and when there's no space for your blood to store uric acid, then it will dump it into the interstitial fluid, which is the area between the cells of your body and or the spaces between the spaces of the muscle structure. And then when this is full or the concentration is too high, the acid will seep further into the synovial fluid. This is synovial fluid. Because this is the end point, there's no way you can dump uric acid anymore. So, and as the uric acid concentration reaches the saturation point, it crystallizes. And when it crystallizes, it forms a tiny particles or crystal that your body thought is a foreign substance. And it launched an immune attack, and it caused inflammation. That is how gout is formed. Okay. Let's look at another scenario is scenario Y, factory Y. All right, okay. The same structure. There's a kidney. Okay, and there's a this same. Yeah, four section. So it gives you a clear idea of how uric acid move in your body or how is distributed in your body, and the same scenario. Okay. This is interstitial fluid, so I just to clarify, this is the interstitial fluid. Okay, this is the area between, and then this is your joint. This is your joint. Okay, this is your joint, and this is your bloodstream. Okay, now here is the catch. All right, here's the very important point is that, all right, here's a scenario is like, okay, you think you have high uric acid, so you reduce the consumption of purine or uric acid. So to 110. So the capacity of kidney is still the same. It can still process 100 units of uric acid out from the body. So there's only excess of 10 units, which will be stored inside the bloodstream. But the problem is your body do not only have one type of acidic waste, which is uric acid, but actually it has many other acidic waste, such as carbonic acid, which is carbon dioxide in the dissolved in the liquid is called carbonic acid, and lactic acid, which is produced by your muscle when it's under extreme stress, especially when you do extreme exercise. So actually, your blood does not only carry uric acid. Your blood is a warehouse for all the. It's a warehouse where it's a buffer zone that so that the carbonic acid will be sent to the lung to be discharged off, and the lactic acid will be sent to the liver to be broken down to other smaller waste so it can get to be disposed out from the body. But you might think, okay, you reduce the consumption of meat or beer or beans, that reduce the input of the raw material into the factory. So there's only a minor excess. But you have to understand, these acids is already occupied a huge space, perhaps maybe 490 units. Like I mentioned, your sewage system and your storage system, which is your blood, can only store 500 units. So when these other acids, I only mentioned two, actually there are many other acidic waste that your body have to handle every single day. So let's say if your body is very acidic already because of other acid, so a minor increment of uric acid can cause the warehouse fully occupied, and the body will dump the uric acid to the interstitial fluid, and eventually it reaches the synovial fluid, and it causes gout inflammation as well. So this is scenario X and scenario Y. And in actual term, in your body, actually these two scenarios happen at the same time. That's why it explains why, especially in the scenario Y, why some people are already having gout for years, and then they decided to control the diet, even though they have reduced the consumption of meat and beer or beans or anything that can cause gout. But the gout attack still comes. One of the reasons why, because there are many other acids that occupy this buffer. And there are some other, the old deposit of uric acid is still in the joint. That's why by cutting down or by controlling your diet will not cure your gout, because it doesn't solve the problem, which is the excess of uric acid stored in the storage area. This is the first area where your, that's why we call it a warehouse, where your body temporarily store the excess raw material or the excess uric acid. But when it's too much, it has to dump into some other places which is not supposed to have uric acid, such as your interstitial fluid and the joints. So in order to cure gout, you need to reverse this process. But the problem with modern medicine is that they give you allopurinol. Allopurinol is something that this is a liver, because it's the liver that supplies the uric acid. Okay, the allopurinol works on here. The allopurinol works here by reducing the supply of the uric acid into the kidney, or the production of uric acid to be exact. But this is not a real solution, because it doesn't solve the problem here, because there's too much acid here. And another thing, the common medicine for gout is colchicine. There are many brands name for it, but the common element is colchicine. Colchicine only deal with the pain, the inflammation, but it doesn't deal with here. The problem, the root cause of your gout problem is there's too much acid in your body. That's why not only you have gout, if a person have too many other uric acid stuck in the bloodstream, cannot be disposed of, he will have many other symptoms such as soreness, and then unexplained symptoms such as rashes on the skin or obesity is all linked to the acid store in this area, your bloodstream, your the space between yourself. This is a huge space. I'm talking about huge space. So what is the solution? That's why you need to pull out the uric acid. You have to clear the uric acid in this area, in the blood, in the interstitial fluid, and eventually you clear the uric acid on your joint. And there's no any chemical medicine or drugs existing in the medical system that works this way. Except that's why you need to think out of the box, is by using a simple logic. Your problem is too much acid store here. That's why you need the help of alkaline, which is the alkaline mineral that you can mix in, you mix into a drinking water, and the drinking, because as you drink water, the alkaline water will go into the bloodstream, and first it will clear the excess acid, not only your acid, all other acids, and then it create more space to buffer the excess uric acid. And at the same time, when there's more space in the blood, then this process will start to reverse. The acids will start to come back to the bloodstream from your interstitial fluid, and eventually from your joint as well. This is how you cure your gout. But this process takes time, depending on how much acid is stored here. So every person, different gout patient have different reaction rate, and there's different kind of healing crisis. Because this process is like moving the acid. And in short, any great movement of acid, especially uric acid in the joint, will trigger a gout attack. So your gout attack because there's a formation of new uric crystal, this direction. But as you drink alkaline, you reverse the process, which you bring out the acid from here. But it will stir up a great movement of uric acid. That's why this, when you drink alkaline to neutralize the excess acid in your body and to cure gout, initial phase for the first few weeks or maybe months, you may experience some weird attacks because your body is moving the acid out. And this phase, you will, for the first few months, you may not notice a significant drop of uric acid. The reason is because they are drawing up the whole all hidden acid from the joint and from the interstitial fluid back to the bloodstream. That's why beginning phase, for the first few weeks or first few months you drink alkaline, you will notice obvious drop of uric acid in your blood test, because a blood test can only show the uric acid in the blood zone, but it doesn't show the changes of uric acid in this zone. There's no test available to show how much uric acid is stored here. So you have to be patient and you understand the logic. That's why it's very important to understand this picture if you want to be free from gout. All right, that's all for now. Thank you.